How can you learn and apply the solid principles? How can you build this solid foundation? Well, the easiest, most straightforward way of learning it is from others.
That's it.
Good, experienced developers that know what they're doing, know what they're talking about.
Yep.
Right? So read the books. But just reading the books is not enough. You need to learn from senior developers, from really experienced people that know the ins and outs of those principles. They can show you what happens if you do it, if you don't, why you should do it, why you shouldn't. Developers that can teach you.
I think it's all about structuring the darkness and the chaos, right? Because once, like the first time you are exposed to these things, to the solid principles, I mean, it's daunting, right? It's scary. So what you want is to find a way to structure and make known, you know, start yes. making known with the maximum acceleration possible, you know, yes. of like learning and understanding these things, right? These principles and all these ideas behind them and how to apply them.
Yes. Theory and practice. You need both.
Exactly.
Especially practice.
Yeah.
You need to apply it and see what happens if you don't as well.
Yes.
You need to see it from multiple angles, in multiple contexts.
Yes.
In different scenarios.
That's why I think like going to people that have been through these things, right? Like, as you said, reading the books is extremely important. But, you know, like these are hard ideas to grasp the first time.
It's counterintuitive.
Scratch that. They're like, you're not gonna understand these things in the first time, right? And even if you think that you understand them, then okay, good luck when you open your ID, you know, your like yeah. Xcode and start applying them. You just like, you need to train, you need to practice a lot to for these things to make sense and
yes.
come intuitive, right?
You need to practice.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're gonna fail. That's fine.
I think that's good. Like if you find yourself in a position where you don't know what to do next or you don't want know what are you violating, that's good. At least yes. you have the idea that you're violating something. You know, like you're mindful that you're violating something. But, you know, it takes some time to understand what exactly are you violating and how you can fix that.
Yes. So choose well your sources, you know, find experienced people, learn from them.
Yes.
If you have like a very good senior developer in your team, just
yep.
pair with them. As much as you can, just be around them and learn as much as you can. Even when it doesn't make sense, ask questions.
Yep.
Read the books. Take notes. Have discussions about it. You know, join a discussion group. That's how you're going to learn. You have to practice and start helping others at some point.
Yeah.
Because as soon as you learn something, you teach it someone else. And you're going to find the gaps in your knowledge when they ask questions or when you're like, every time you say, I think. Yeah, you're not that sure.
Yeah.
Read again, apply again, practice, ask your mentors. That's how you're going to get there.
Exactly.
And that's how you go fast, by learning from people that know what they're doing. They're good at teaching and they want to teach you.
Yes.